I'm too sexy for my love, too sexy for my love. Love's going to leave me.
Stop for a second and think about who the target audience is for this program. What is the ideology behind this cartoon image? According to Douglas Kellner, television, film, and the other media culture provide materials out of which we forge our very identities, our sense of selfhood, our notion of what it means to be male or female.
I'm too sexy for your party, too sexy for your party.
The roles of women vary throughout the history of cartoons, and there are new roles of female characters that are strong, independent, and also intelligent. Many of the cartoons today portray female characters as the strong and confident heroines or even as supervillains. Female characters are taking over the roles of typical male characters, while the discourse of femininity remains the same. Femininity was always displayed as weak, delicate, sexy, seductive, and submissive. Furthermore, a research done on cartoons from the 1970s compared the gender roles in animated cartoons. It showed that compared to female characters, male characters were given much more prominence, appeared more frequently, engaged in more of almost all of the noted behaviors, and talked significantly more.
You want emergency? There's a handsome guy in my house.
Even post-World War II, where there was a dramatic increase of women in the labor workforce, the War Office was extremely concerned about women's identity and their loss of the physical definition of femininity in terms of the curving hips, since women were dressing in men's uniforms. Although the messages behind these new female characters are dominant, independent, intelligent, tough, and daring, sadly, the depictions of body images and sexuality remain the same as before.
Folks, your pretty face! And don't underestimate the importance of body language!
Ursula, the female villain in Disney's Little Mermaid, summarizes the imagery used by cartoon producers to portray femininity in their cartoons. According to Rosalind, there is a rise of the body culture within the last decade, and there is a growing interest and concern in the appearance of the human body. Wonder Woman and Catwoman are highly sexualized representations, which positions them as the object of the male gaze despite their protagonist roles, rather than as a threat to the masculine order. This is demonstrated through the pairing of their hyper-feminine features such as tiny waist, long hair, large breasts, with fetishistic signifiers such as their leather suits and whips.
Together, big boy. I think you're cute. Hubba, hubba.
Almost all of the female characters have the big eyes, pouty lips, small waist, and slender hourglass figures, which give a message to the children audience how a girl should look like and what the society's expectation of a woman is. Our society has normalized provocative nature in respect to our young viewers' minds.
She's stunning. She's got a waist about that big. She's got a beautiful, curvaceous figure. She's got a great face.
Pucker up.
You must walk feminine, talk feminine, smile and beguile feminine. Utilize your femininity. That's what every girl should know.
Are children just expected to disregard these sexualized portrayals of girls and women? Or are they expected to have developed a conscience to decipher these created images from actual reality? By giving female characters these roles, we then ask, how do these roles fit into the images given to these characters? How do children learn about such things as what a woman should be like? What are the ideologies that are implemented subconsciously in our children's minds? Rosalind Gill summarizes that advertisements, scholars, and contemporary society inform women tomorrow's values are feminine. However, popular culture is becoming increasingly hypersexual and objectifying women's bodies. This may serve as a counterattack against feminism. By combining the powerful, knowledgeable, and independent mindset of women with their hypersexualized objectification of their bodies, depictions of women in this way makes them sexual subjects instead of just mere objects.
I wish I could tie you up. I was told I was beautiful, but what does that mean?
The ideology behind what a woman or a girl should look like is determined not by the female audiences, but by the creators and or the corporations. The white supremacist capitalist patriarchy is preserving these female characters within the feminine line through such sexualized representations of women, even in cartoons. If we continue to allow children to be exposed to such degrading texts, then it could lead to low self-esteem and high expectations for the self, creating obsession over body images. Since we cannot control what the mass media are producing, we can only educate our children and give them further information about sexuality, especially within the cartoons they watch.